Thank you. Myself, Dr. Senthil Kumaran, associate working in Department of Forensic Medicine and Toxicology at All India Institute of Medical Science and Mangalagiri. This is more like a review literature, which I have done. Since we are in a starting phase of our institute, we want to establish a poison information center. So when going through, I thought it would be a presentation where I can tell about a poison information center, which is the need of the hour, but none of the institute or state governments are paying much interest in establishing a poison information center. So coming on to the introduction, poisoning is a significant global public health problem with nearly 1 million deaths reported each year. According to National Crime Records Bureau also, according to, in 2018, there was a total of 35,862 deaths in India, which happened due to poisoning alone. And most common poisoning in India involves insecticides, rodenticides, snake bites, alcohol, sedatives, hypnotics, opiates, and other pain medication over the counter drugs also, which plays a main part in case of poisoning in India. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. So when we thought of poisoning information center, when it got started through around the world, the first poison information service center started in Netherlands in 1949, which is almost 72 years have passed on. So in England, Leeds in 1961, they have started telephone answering service for poison information center around 1961, which is almost 60 years away. And National Poison Information Service was established at Guy's Hospital, London in 1963. So we can see the timelines around the world, some around 7 decades before the Poison Information Center came into picture. Okay, next slide, please. So we can see in 1950, which is got established in throughout the world, first Poison Information Center was started in 1950, but it came to India like in AIIMS, New Delhi, under the Department of Pharmacology. They established National Poison Information Center around 1995 only. After nearly some 4 to 5 decades after, they have established the first Poison Information Center. Then the first Poison Information Center in South India was formally inaugurated at Government General Hospital in Chennai around 2001, nearly after 50 years. And Amrita Institute of Medical Sciences, Cochin, established Poison Information and Analytical Service in 2003. Next slide, please. Next slide. So there is no importance of establishing Poison Information Center, not only in India, around the world also. There is no much importance have been put into effort to establish a Poison Information Center. It has been rejected right from the beginning. For starting a poison control center, you should have a poison information center and a poison analytical lab also. But you can realize establishing a poison information center is too much turmoil for all the states and all the institutes are put together. Then the next step of poison control center, it's a still more tedious charges with so much funds required. Globally, poisoning is an under-recognized and under-reported major public health concern throughout the world, not only in India. While the World Health Organization, WHO, recommends that all countries establish and strengthen poison information center, nearly half of the WHO members only have started to establish poison information center. Next slide, please. So in these slides, you can see these are the various poison information centers which have been in, according to WHO data, only these are the WHO recognized poison information center. Yet till 2019, there was only 6 poison information center which has been recognized by WHO has been established in India, in different parts of India. Okay. Thank you. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. So what is the beneficiary of establishing a poison information center? Previous slide, please. So what is the beneficiary of establishing a poison information center? By establishing a poison information center, it can reduce the morbidity and mortality in that area. Mild poisoning cases which gets frightened can be readily treated by first aid measures alone, because snake bites and other things they have reported, like main cause of death in a snake bite is due to frightening, where they get vasovagal shock or something, the person might die. So mild poisoning cases that can be treated by first aid measures alone, if there is a well-established poison information center, they can guide them by giving a first aid measure in case of non-poisonous snake bite. So That is thing. And severe poisoning cases which need special facilities and equipment for treatment are sent directly to hospitals. Specific antidotes, therapeutic agents, and medical equipment more easily available for the person requiring it. Prevent the unnecessary, expensive, sophisticated treatments. Epidemiological basis for local toxicovigilance. This is the main part which is required in India right now. So they have to, whenever they are establishing some companies or some industries, they have to find out what are the chemicals which gets liberated from the industry and how to prevent that thing, so that in the local hospital, they can have the protective measures to prevent that poisoning when it happens. Okay, toxicovigilance plays an important role. The education and training you can give to the person who are handling these chemicals. Poison information centers are important source of information on human toxicology, which can guide in various research processes and also to establish a proper toxicovigilance facilities in that area. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. So these are the poison information centers which are recognized by WHO in India. This is the latest document. According to WHO in India, there are totally nine poison information centers which has been recognized in India by WHO. There are some other poison information centers, like example, if you take AIIMS Bhopal, they have one poison information center. If you take in South, you have St. John's Medical Hospitals in Bangalore, they have a poison information center. They are having poison information center, which is not recognized by WHO. Okay, and mainly this poison information provides a data. It is not functioning throughout 24/7. They are only functioning for a certain period of time. After that, you don't get the information from this center. And also, there is no any dedicated service which has been given. And mostly these poison information centers, they provide information only a clinician or a medico calls that center. It is not open to public or some other person who calls any doubts regarding some poison substance. Okay, so these are the nine poison information centers which was recognized by WHO in India. Next slide, please. So these are the major gas leaks which has happened previously. So these are the major gas leaks which has happened in India, and mainly these things have happened, and it has happened from Bhopal gas tragedy in 1984. Then subsequently various other gas leaks and other things has happened. But these gas leaks, whenever it happens, it comes into news. Other than that, there is nothing more important has happened after that, because whenever there is establishment of some industries, there should be some toxicovigilance should be happening, and what are the chemicals which is stored in the that industry, and when it get released, what are the protective measures one has to take. Okay, there is no any educational reforms or something which is happening. Next thing. Next slide, please. So this is one of the things which has happened recently in Andhra Pradesh. Since I am from Andhra Pradesh, I like to elaborate on these cases. So there was one gas leak which has happened in Vizag in Andhra Pradesh. So there is a release of styrene glass from one of the LG Polymers company, but people are unaware of that thing. So it is in an industry, the poison leak has happened, but people are unaware when these gas leaks happen, what are the protective measures they have to take and how to take and take care of these people who are affected in this area. This is due to lack of toxicovigilance, which is happening. Excuse me. Next slide. Next slide, please. So another case which is reported as a mysterious virus in Eluru in Andhra Pradesh, where the people in some village near to that area, they have suffered some sickness, and people are aware of that, whether it is due to some virus disease or some other thing. Later on investigation, it has proved the people has consumed water which is high in lead and mercury, which leads to mysterious disease. And because people are not having this toxic vigilance in that area, where the nearby factories, what chemicals gets released in water, if they consume, what kind of sickness they go through. Since this information is not available, so people are getting assumption and they are treated in a wrong way. So people are the sufferer. Okay, next slide. So vision for future, in India, a few poison information section exist, but there is no regional integration poison control and information center that can be readily accessed by people in the community where poisoning occurs. And there is a need of for states in India to provide affordable life-saving poison control information, toxicological surveillance, treatment referral, and poison prevention. Thank you.